नमस्कार, अ वॉर्म वेलकम टू द 100th एपिसोड ऑफ ग्रंथ यात्रा. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द नॉवेल उद्या, विच मीन्स टुमॉरो, बाय राइटर नंदा खरे. दिस रीसेंट नॉवेल, विच वॉज पब्लिश्ड इन 2015, एक्सप्लोर्स द रैपिड पेस ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट्स, देयर इफेक्ट्स ऑन द लाइव्स ऑफ ह्यूमन्स एंड द चेंजेस दैट इट ब्रिंग्स अबाउट इन द वैल्यू सिस्टम्स. At the same time, it also peers into the future and warns the humanity about the possible dangers that it could face. The writer provides the readers with a glimpse of the power play between those who will have access to technology and others. Writer Nanda Khare's original name was Anant Yashwant Khare. He was born in the year 1946. After completing his schooling from Nagpur, Khare obtained a B.Tech degree in civil engineering from IIT Mumbai. Subsequently, he worked as a civil engineer in a private company until the year 2001. He made a significant contribution to the Ujjaini Dam on River Bhima. Alongside his professional work, Khare was also a trustee for the rationalist magazine Aajcha Sudharak, which he also edited for some years. Khare's writings, whether his original works or translations of other writers, focus on social, historical and scientific themes. His novels Antajichi Bakhar, Bakhar Antakalachi and Udya are particularly famous. Through all these writings, Khare propagated rationalistic and scientific thought. The novel Udya mostly unfolds through first-person narratives of its characters. At the beginning of the novel, we are introduced to Sudeep Joshi, who works as a translator in a company. Sudeep is in great difficulty as he has lost his identity. In reality, what he has lost is his identity card. But the futuristic times in which he lives, this identity card is not just used for gaining entry to his office, but is necessary for every action of his life. Without his identity card, Sudeep cannot buy food or anything else, cannot take a bus to his office or avail any other service necessary to lead a normal life in the city. In short, humans have lost their individuality in the society to which Sudeep belongs. Khare writes, "Now, if all cards such as that which keeps the time, the credit card and my identity card were combined into one, my entire identity can be stored in this card. The organization that I work for is a separate entity and the organization from where I purchase things is a different entity. The organization that marks me with a QR code, the administrative system that marks me with alphanumeric code is different. But is that really true? I'm not sure. What I am certain is that I have lost my individuality." The other prominent characters in this novel are Arun and Anu. Arun is a cybersecurity expert and his wife Anu is a senior bureaucrat. The society that they are part of is monitored by the administration through numerous cameras that spy on people. With the help of computers, Arun analyzes the emotions captured by these cameras. Arun has been appointed to a Naxalite area. He is constantly under stress because of the tense relations between the local political parties, the power at the center, and the Naxalites, as well as the politics between the law enforcement agencies. Arun's son is a brilliant student, but Arun is aware that despite securing good scores in the civil services exam, his son will never make it to the top foreign postings. On this background, both Arun and Anu receive attractive job offers from an international private company. Both accept these offers, but by the time they realize that they are only toys in the hands of this company, it is too late. Yet another character in this novel is Sachidananda Bhakre, who is an ordinary school teacher in Amaravati district. He has followed his teaching career with sincerity despite facing hardships in life. Because of his helping nature, he has a large social circle. Bhakare has been a witness to the deteriorating value system in the society, the exploitation of common man by the gigantic international companies, the rising crimes and hunting of women who are regarded as mere objects of desire. His own brilliant students are finding it difficult to cope in this rat race. One of his students working in an international company says, "That is only on paper, sir. Authentic research requires a lot of money. Today, I can design lenses as well as chips. But one model succeeds after 7 or 8 trials. And if I want to try something even a little bit different, it could cost anywhere between 1 to 100 million. How can I get that amount of money if all I am doing is assembling the product, sir? I can only attend the research brainstorming workshops. They then feed me for a week or a month, sponsor my vacations to Matheran, Shimla, or occasionally to Germany. And after all the discussions, award me with labels such as most innovative or the most dynamic. They give me medals and watches, 8-day trips, and then their German or Dutch lads develop my ideas. All I am left to do is enjoy a week-long holiday in Monaco or Tuscany." In this world where a common man has been turned into a puppet, 4 villages at the border between modern capitalism and the Naxalites are collectively trying to live a life of idealism. They follow a self-sustaining economy, take their decisions with consensus, and conserve nature. A young woman journalist is sent to the difficult terrain where these people live as a punishment posting and is asked to report on their lives. Through the observations of this reporter, Sanika, the readers get to know about the life of this unique commune. Kare writes, "Although Nagodada is a friend, a guide and philosopher to the 4 villages, he is not alone. Agricultural difficulties are solved in consultation with Bhau Kohare. All problems related to animals are taken to Sujata Tajane. Dr. Bhaguji takes care of ailments and injuries. Teaching children is the job of almost everyone. Ramu Reddy ensures that the expense books are maintained properly. The border posts are patrolled by Didi. Government officers and government schemes is the responsibility of Samir Kondawar." In the latter part of the novel, the tales of all these characters come together to create a dystopian future. The life of city dwellers has turned mechanical in this world imagined by the author. To survive in this world, association with bullies of organizations such as Mahikadal has become inevitable. Years of female infanticide has led to a drastically decreased number of women. As a result, it is impossible for decent men to get married and raise a family. The rich and powerful hunt women and turn them into slaves. Several political parties are involved in this hunting to supply women to the rich. Honest officers and bright students from small towns are falling victims to the greed of big private companies. The political system and these international private companies are hand in glove at many levels. The future of the idealistic 4 villages is uncertain in this world. On the orders of some unknown person or organization, the police attack these 4 villages after branding its residents as Naxalites. Thus, Sanika, who has been documenting the ideal life of its villagers and their life's philosophy, survive this attack? Do Arun and Anu manage to escape the clutches of the capitalist company? What does Sudeep Joshi's relatives go through after the death of his brother-in-law, and what turn does his own life take? To know all this and to understand the reasoning behind its conclusion, it is essential to read the novel in the original. Let us now hear from Professor Mona Chimote about this novel that falls in the category of dystopian fiction.
नंदा खरे हे मराठी साहित्यातील एक चिंतनशील व व्यासंगी साहित्यिक म्हणून ओळखले जातात. नंदा खरे यांनी अस्वस्थ काळाची स्पंदनं हृदयात घेऊन त्यांची वैचारिक चिकित्सा आपल्या साहित्यातून केली आहे. नंदा खरे यांची उद्या ही कादंबरी एक डिस्टोपियन शैलीतील कादंबरी म्हणून ओळखली जाते. डिस्टोपियन आणि युटोपियन या साहित्यातील दोन भिन्न शैली आहेत. त्या समाजाच्या दोन भिन्न दृष्टिकोनांचा वेध घेतात. डिस्टोपियन साहित्यातून नियंत्रित केलेल्या समाजाचे किंवा तांत्रिक प्रगतीचा वाढता वापर, पर्यावरणाचा ऱ्हास, वाढती लोकसंख्या इत्यादींच्या मानवी आयुष्यावर होणाऱ्या परिणामांचे चित्रण या साहित्यातून केले जाते. डिस्टोपियन साहित्यातील सर्वात महत्त्वाचं उदाहरण म्हणजे जॉर्ज ऑरवेल यांची 1984 ही कादंबरी होय. डिस्टोपियनची विरोधी बाजू म्हणजे युटोपियन होय. या युटोपियन साहित्यात समाजात सर्वत्र सुख, शांतता, समता आणि समृद्धी नांदताना दिसते. मराठी साहित्यात युटोपियन साहित्याची अपवादात्मक का होईना काही उदाहरणं सापडतात, पण डिस्टोपियन शैलीतील एकमेव उदाहरण म्हणून नंदा खरे यांच्या उद्या या कादंबरीचा उल्लेख करता येईल. नंदा खरे यांनी आपल्या कादंबरीचं शीर्षक जरी उद्या हे घेतलं असलं तरी काल, आज आणि उद्या या तिन्ही काळांना कवेत घेणारी ही कादंबरी आहे. आज आणि भविष्यात कॉर्पोरेटीकरणाच्या बुलडोझरखाली चिरडल्या जाणाऱ्या समाजाचे प्रत्येकाचे चित्रण त्यांनी आपल्या कादंबरीतून केलं आहे. केवळ नफा तोट्याच्या हिशेबात मूल्यवृद्धीकडे पळत सुटलेल्या मानवी आयुष्याची केविलवाणी धडपड ते नितीन भक्ते या प्रातिनिधिक पात्राच्या माध्यमातून नोंदवितात. स्वातंत्र्य, समता, बंधुता या मूल्यांपैकी केवळ प्रत्येकाची धाव ही स्वातंत्र्याकडे आहे, पण हे स्वातंत्र्य समता आणि बंधुतेला मारक ठरणार आहे याकडे मात्र प्रत्येकाचं दुर्लक्ष होत असल्याचं नंदा खरे यांनी ठिकठिकाणी आपल्या कादंबरीतून विविध घटनांमधून दाखवून दिलं आहे. त्यांनी या कादंबरीची रचना 15 प्रकरणात विभागली आहे. प्रत्येक प्रकरण हे अत्यंत वैशिष्ट्यपूर्ण आहे. यात पहिल्या प्रकरणातील पात्र ही दुसऱ्या प्रकरणात न भेटता ही पुढील प्रकरणात अधूनमधून भेटतात. मध्ये मध्ये वापरलेली रूपक, उदाहरणार्थ खनिज संपत्तीने परिपूर्ण प्रदेशांना बळकवण्याचे कटकारस्थान उलगडून दाखविणारं लक्ष्मीचं पाऊल हे प्रकरण, किंवा प्रजा ही टिकाऊ हवी नुसती बहुसंख्य नको हा विवेकी विचार बिंबविणारं दिवाणखाण्यातील हत्ती हे प्रकरण, खाजगीपणा हरवणारं KYC चा विळखा उलगडून दाखवणारं तंबूतला उंट हे प्रकरण. या कादंबरीचे कथानक विविध घटना घडामोडींचा अन्वय लावत पुढे सरकतं. व्यवसायाच्या निमित्तानं येणारे कॉर्पोरेट जगतातील अनुभव, महानगरातील सर्वसामान्यांचं जगणं, तंत्रज्ञानाचा वापर करून त्यांचं आयुष्य हे सर्वेलन्सखाली येणं, माणसाची स्वतंत्र ओळख पुसून त्याचं अस्तित्व हे केवळ आकड्यात बंदिस्त होणं, संशोधक, शास्त्रज्ञ आणि व्यावसायिक यांच्यातील फरक, सामान्यांपुढे बिलगेट्स सारखे उभे केलेले धनाढ्य व्यावसायिक आदर्श, नको त्या आजारांना दिलं जाणारं महत्व आणि त्या आधारे मिळवली जाणारी आर्थिक मदत, दानदात्यांची प्रसिद्धी लोलूपता, लोकप्रतिनिधींकडून समाजातील मूळ प्रश्नांकडे सोयीस्कररित्या केलेलं दुर्लक्ष, पोलीस यंत्रणा व त्यांचे लागेबंधे, नोकरवर्गाची गुलामी मानसिकता, मंत्रालयातील कर्मचारी आणि कंत्राटदार यांचे साटेलोटे, लोकशाही विचारातून पुढे आलेल्या लोकोपयोगी प्रकल्पांचे हळूहळू होत चाललेले खासगीकरण, ग्रामीण जीवनातील विदीर्ण वास्तव, स्त्रियांचे घटते प्रमाण आणि त्यांचे वडील वाढता अत्याचार, मूल्य ह्रास करत मूल्यवृद्धीची अहमामिका, अशा अनेक प्रश्नांचा वेध घेत ही कादंबरी अत्यंत कलात्मकतेने गुंफलेली आपल्याला जाणवते। नंदा खरे यांना असणारी वास्तवाची प्रगल्भ जाण, सूक्ष्म निरीक्षण शक्ती, जागतिक साहित्याचं वाचन आणि त्याचे अचूक संदर्भ नोंदविण्याचं कौशल्य, दंतकथा, रूपक कथा यांचा अप्रतिम वापर करण्याची शैली, वैज्ञानिक आणि भौतिक प्रगतीचं ज्ञान आणि मानवी मानसशास्त्राचं अचूक आकलन या त्यांच्या प्रातिभिक वैशिष्ट्यातून उद्या कादंबरीचं कथानक पुढे सरकतं। ही कादंबरी कथा, ललित लेख, सरळ निवेदन, शासकीय टिप्पण्या असा आकृतीबंध स्वीकारत बोलींचे असंख्य पदर उलगडत पुढे पुढे सरकते। खरे या कादंबरीत संस्कृत, प्रमाण मराठी, दखनी, वराडी, हिंदी, पंजाबी, कोळी, हैदराबादी हिंदी, बंबईया हिंदी आणि इंग्रजी अशा विविध बोलींचा सुरेख वापर करतात। आपणच स्वतः व्यक्तिगत न राहता आपल्यावर अनेक बाजूंनी नियंत्रण मिळवणारी यंत्रणा सुसज्ज असल्याचं भान ही कादंबरी वाचकांना आणून देते, नवे सावधगिरीचा इशारा देते। मुळातून ही कादंबरी सर्वांनी वाचावी हीच कळकळीची विनंती।
The novel Udya effectively depicts the conflict between all the constituents of a society who are caught in a dangerous maze at many levels, from the villages to megacities on the one hand, and the residents of the four villages who offer an alternative to this maze by leading an environment-friendly life of non-violence. Although the novel depicts an imaginary world, the social, political, and economic streams leading to it are visible even today in varying degrees. If humans are not careful, the world described in the novel could become a reality. That is the message conveyed by Nanda Khare through his novel Udya. In the year 2020, the Sahitya Academy Award was announced for this novel. However, following his decision made in 2017 to not accept any more awards, Khare declined to accept it. Do read this important novel that explores the social and individual value systems in future. For the last 3.5 years, we have been discussing well-known books in Marathi literature through the Granth Yatra series. 64 professors, writers, and thinkers have taken part in this series as experts. Several critics helped with their contribution. On behalf of Granth Yatra, a heartfelt thank you to all of them. This initiative has been successful because of the spontaneous response given by viewers like you. Do register your responses on Granth Yatra's YouTube channel. Spread the word about this series and suggest the channel to anyone looking for information on Marathi literature. Granth Yatra will continue. Watch this space to find out which new books will come in the limelight through this series. Tell us which books you would like us to feature. Looking forward to meeting you again. Until then, keep reading.